This is a Friday Shoes production. Today's lesson is 4-1 in our books on page 190. And the target is I can express ratios and fractions in simplest form and determine unit rates. So again, we're talking about ratios and rates. First thing we'll talk about is a ratio. A ratio is a comparison of two numbers or quantities by division. If an orange paint contains 2 drops of yellow paint and 4 drops of red paint, the ratio comparing yellow paint to red paint can be written as follows. This would be how you write a ratio. There's 3 different ways. You can use the word 2, and it would look like this. 2 to 4, in this case, 2 yellow drops to 4 red drops of paint. Or you can use the colon, 2:4, same, 2 to 4. That's another way to say it. Or use the fraction bar, which would be just 2/4. Again, 2 yellow drops to 4 red drops of paint. Those are the 3 ways to write a ratio. In this case, it says, express each ratio in simplest form. So now we have number one here, 3 nonfiction books out of 12 books. How do we write that in ratio format? Well, it's basically 3 books to 12 books. So we put 3/12, they're using the fraction bar this time, and that's equal to 1/4. So the ratio of nonfiction books to books is 1/4 or 1/4. How about number 2 here? 20 minutes of exercise to 1 hour of studying. Now take a look at this because we've got minutes and hours. When writing ratios that compare quantities with the same kinds of units, convert so that they have the same units. What I find is if you take the larger unit like hours here and change that to minutes, it seems to work out best. So take a look at what they do here. They take 20 minutes over 1 hour. That'd be the first ratio that we write, 20 minutes to 1 hour. But then we convert the hour to 60 minutes, as you can see right here. Now, 20 minutes to 60 minutes can then be reduced to 1/3. 20 over 60 is 1/3. And we can cancel out the minutes. One on top, one on bottom. That means they're common. They can be reduced or eliminated. The ratio of exercise or the ratio of exercise to study in simplest form is 1/3 or 1.3, 1:3, however you want to say that. It's 1/3. That's how I say it. All right, express each ratio in simplest form on your own here. Try these A and B. Come back, see how you do after I do them. All right, 16 pepperoni pizzas out of 24 pizzas. Simply put your 16 all over 24, and these are pizzas. I'm going to have those canceled out anyways, and I'm going to reduce 16 over 24. What goes into 16 that also goes into 24? 8. So I'm literally just reducing this by dividing by 8, and I've got myself 2 on top, and I've got 3 on bottom. So it's 2/3, or 2/3, or 2/3. Either way you want to write it. How about B here? 8 ounces of butter to 1 pound of flour. So we've got 8 ounces to 1 pound of flour. That'll be our fraction. Now I noticed that pounds and ounces are not the same, so I'm going to convert the pounds into ounces. This is something you need to just kind of have memorized from sixth grade and below, that how many ounces are there in a pound? Well, there's 16 ounces in a pound. You can also find that in your assignment notebook, I believe. They have a nice little sheet there that has all that information. Keep the same information on the top. So we have 8 ounces over 16 ounces, which is actually a pound. Cross out your ounces and reduce your 8/16 to 1.5, or excuse me, 1/2. So we're dividing both sides by, or both top and bottom by 8. So there's our ratio. It's 1/2. All right, let's talk about rates. A rate is a ratio that compares two quantities with different types of units, such as it costs $5 for 2 pounds or 130 miles in 2 hours. Notice that there are two different units. There's dollar sign here, and then there's pounds here. There's miles here, and then there's hours here. So when a rate is simplified, so it has a denominator of 1, it is called a unit rate. Basically, if you took the two numbers, 5, in this case right here, 5 divided by 2, or 130 divided by 2, you'd be getting the unit rate. Let's take a look at this first example here, number 3. It says Lloyd's worked on Saturday for 6 hours, or Lloyd worked on Saturday for 6 hours and earned $40. What was Lloyd's average rate of pay in dollars per hour? So we're looking for dollars per hour. Per, in our math world, typically means divide. So literally take your dollars and divide by your hours. That's only if you remember now that per means divide. It kind of tells you what to do. So let's take our dollars and divide by our hours. It says write the rate that expresses the comparison of dollars to hours, then find the average rate of pay by finding the unit rate. And that's actually what they're going to do here. They line it up with $40 over 6 hours, which is division. Remember that fraction bar means divide. Then they're going to divide by 6. Basically, you're taking 40 divided by 6. This is really what you're doing here. 40 divided by 6. And you get 6.67. They rounded it all over 1. You'll get this on your calculator. You just put it over 1, and that means out of 1 hour. So you have $40 divided by 6 gives you $6.67 per 1 hour. So Lloyd earned an average of about $6.67 per hour. How about you try these two? Come on back and see what you get in comparison to what I have. It says express each rate as a unit rate. Here's C, 24 tickets for 8 rides. Well, I'm gonna try to figure out how many tickets it takes per ride. So let's go 24 tickets divided by 8 rides. When you do that, here's what you end up with. If you take 24 divided by 8, you get 3. That means 3 tickets per ride. Basically, I divided the top by 8 and I divided the bottom by 8. You got 1 on the bottom then, and you got 3 on top. So 3 tickets per 1 ride. How about the second one? 4 inches of rain in 5 hours. So let's take our 4 inches, pull it over 5 hours, and then divide the top and the bottom by 5. You're always dividing by that bottom number to get your unit rate. When you do that, you get 0.8 here. That's an eighth of an inch. Excuse me, not an eighth of an inch. 8/10 of an inch over 1 hour. Because you see that 5 divided by 5 becomes 1. So literally, we just divided 4 divided by 5. Same with this first one. All we really do is take the 24 and divide by the bottom number, or the 8, and that's what you're going to get. Your bottom unit always becomes 1 then. That's why this one became 0.8. All right, let's take a look at this. The population of Pennsylvania is about 12,300,000, and the population of Kentucky is about 4 million. If there are 19 members of the U.S. House of Representatives from Pennsylvania and 6 from Kentucky, in which state does a member represent more people? Well, let's take a look. We take our 12,300,000 people, and we divide by the 19 representatives for Pennsylvania, and we end up with 650,000 people per one of the representatives. For each representative, there's 650,000 people they represent. In Kentucky, you take the 4 million and you divide by 6 representatives and end up with 670,000 people per one representative. Therefore, if you look at it, real simple, a member represents more people in Kentucky than in Pennsylvania, roughly about 20,000 more people. Let's do a little bit more comparison shopping type, an example that you probably see more often here. And this is the comparison of products and their dollar amounts, and if you're buying more or less of that product, which one's a better deal? It says decide which is the better buy. Explain your reasoning. How about you try E and F on your own? See if you can do what I just did on that previous example. Come on back, see how you do. All right, so we have 17-ounce box of cereal for $4.89 or a 21-ounce box for $5.69. Which one would be a better deal? Which one are you getting more product for less money? Well, simply take, in this first case right here, let's take our $4.89 and divide it by 17 ounces. When we do that, we end up with roughly 29 cents per ounce. When you do that with the 21-ounce box at $5.69 divide that by 21 ounces, you end up getting 27 cents per ounce. Which one's a better buy? You spend less for this 1 ounce if you buy this box right here. Now it's close, but it's still a better buy. And we're not really comparing how much you really want to buy. Some people say, well, I'm going to buy 21 ounces. I need 21 ounces. We're just looking for which is the best buy per ounce. All right, how about this one? 6 cans of green beans for a dollar or 10 cans for $1.95. Which one's a better deal? Well, let's take our dollar divided by 6 cans. When we do that, we end up with roughly 17 cents. When we take the $1.95 and divide by 10 cans, excuse me, that's a divide sign, you roughly get 19.5 cents, or we'll round it to 20 cents. I rounded the 17 cents as well. If you notice, that first deal is better. You can buy 6 cans of green beans for $1, and that would save you roughly 3 cents per can. That's it. But don't forget, if you're not understanding, you can always rewatch the video. You could read the examples in the book. You could watch the personal tutor videos and the resources on the online textbook. Don't forget to take your NYQA quiz. And of course, this has been a Friday Shoes production.